team fight.
Yeah.
We're a few minutes away from the draft. Two teams you've probably seen are headed back to their booths right now. So we'll take some social media questions that we've been doing all week. This is a particularly fun one, Peter.
Oh boy.
You might like this one. This one's from CrypticS91. What hero do you associate with personality-wise?
Who's it for?
It's for all three of you. But Peter, you can go first.
Who's the saltiest hero in Dota?
One
of the fish creatures.
I don't play with hero voices, so I don't really hear all like the little passive-aggressive quips they throw out. So, I don't know. Do you guys know any heroes that are just...
All right, Charlie, pick a hero that associates
with
Peter.
I'll choose Peter.
I mean, Triad's the obvious one, right?
Yeah, no, we're not doing that. We're not doing that. What's a really salty hero?
One of the fish ones, maybe?
No. I mean, there are some with, like, voice lines that, like...
Bad question. Let's move on.
Yeah.
Better, like,
I mean, this is better with Slacks on the panel that knows all the lore, that knows all the background of these heroes.
Shut down straight away.
I agree. We should definitely get you off the panel and get Slacks in here.
Let's do it.
Come on, Slacks.
We'll take one more. I'm ready. Just before they head into the draft. This one's from 13th Monkey. What would be your Dota 2 dream team?
Dream team?
Yeah.
And you... Are we going to say he can't say, like, his own players? Or?
Yeah, can't take any of your own players.
All right.
Well, so if you picked a five, who would they be? Let's pick a four, because obviously you'd be the captain. So pick a four around you.
Okay.
Oh.
What would be the dreams? You'd have Miracle.
Miracle? I don't know.
Would you?
Not after that last game.
Yeah, I don't want that 8th Death Invoker. I want the zero deaths for four games. Maybe, like, TI3 Alliance with me in there.
Okay. Who would you be replacing then?
I would replace... I'd have to practice my Chen a little bit, but maybe Ake.
Okay.
Nice. Charlie, got a dream team from this particular tournament? Or even a dream team overall?
TI5 EG, man.
That would be a dream. You're so boring, Charlie.
That's pretty boring.
Yeah. LD, come on.
Let's see. So at this event, I would say probably Miracle, Kaka. I'll keep him together with Chuan because they've been playing so well. I need a safe laner.
An off laner.
And an off laner. What do you guys think? Any suggestions?
I really like
Mutombo Man as well, so I think I'll take Mutombo Man as my safe laner.
And then you need an off laner?
Yeah. I'll take Bulldog. Just for the memes.
You're going to say that?
Every team needs a clown.
Exactly.
Okay, we'll take some social media questions a bit later on, but the draft is up and running. There's no bans just yet, so we have a chance to talk about what they might do in this one, Peter. Lifesteal has got to go this time.
Maybe. I don't necessarily think they need to ban it. It's probably a decent idea. But this is the winner bracket. If they do lose, they get another shot. Maybe they're committed to beating Lifestealer. Just Batrider's not the choice.
You're the master of these winner bracket games. You've lost many.
I've lost so many. And then come back up the other way, right?
But in terms of, is that mind game? What are you doing, Peter?
Losing is learning, man. Like, you lose a game, you come back, you're like, why'd we lose? And then you come back and beat it.
So you guys learned a lot this event then.
No, we didn't even get to play very many games, so not too much learning.
Oh, jeez.
How much
do you think it affects the matchup? Like, a lot of teams have been banning the Miracle Invoker. Even first phase, do you think that's like a concern for OG at all, that he loses that game?
One thing I didn't like about last game is how they first two of their cores. I'm a big fan of kind of waiting on that and maybe counterpicking the cores that Newbee would pick. So maybe they go for something else first two, maybe pick up one of their supports since they seem to kind of be defaulting to Fly playing one of three heroes throughout most of their drafts. Maybe his hero isn't so important to save for later in the draft.
And OG are going to have first pick this time, but they still ban the Lifestealer. It's not as much of a go-to for them.
They thought they could beat it. They were wrong. So let's ban it this time. And
you give
try
Newbee Lifestealer.
I mean, this is their fifth try or something, right?
Well, they also have first pick this time, too, so it shows that they're not incredibly confident with the hero, as Newbee is.
Newbee showing the IO the respect I think it deserves, taking that tool away from OG.
It's always been a Western hero.
Yeah. DK TI4 era played it pretty well.
There's always been
lowercase
a
super.
A couple of exemptions, but yeah.
By and large, definitely a Western hero. They're really taking their time with this
Phoenix
second
Phoenix might make it through, we'll see.
Yeah, so Phoenix is probably one of the big ones.
I think that's going to be our first pick from OG, most likely. That was something as well OG didn't have last time, was that healer kind of hero, whether it was a Juggernaut, a Dazzle, Wisp, Phoenix. So
out of the ones in vogue, probably the Phoenix the most successful here.
Yeah, definitely. those first two banned from Newbee last game, and for good reason.
They didn't have anything to really save anybody. You saw Miracle got gone on a lot, and if he got initiated on, he was more or less just dead.
Yeah, they had Venge, but like with Slaughter Amp and Lifestealer popping out, any hero's dying in less than a second.
How much do you value having like a crit roaming hero? Like Earth Spirit's the big one.
Oh, Ricky Ban, wow. I don't necessarily think it's needed. I think that they just need to do better in their lanes. That's what Dota always comes down to, is how well do you do in your lanes. And OG did not do well.
So OG get first pick. Phoenix out there.
As is the Earth Spirit. Yeah. Mm. It offers another form of initiation, unlike last game where they were just relying on Moon.
And Newbee are dire again. They do tend to favor like the strong Roche-taking heroes on that side, especially. We see most teams like that. Prophet, Slardar are still available.
Dire has been heavily favored this tournament.
59 wins from 88 games so far.
Oh, wow.
More than 67% win rate. Yeah.
Closing on 70.
For Dire?
Yeah.
Makes sense.
You've seen a lot of teams this tournament. If they're behind, they take Roche on.
Did OG take Radiant in the last game?
They were Radiant. They were Radiant's second pick, which is the interesting thing.
Oh, okay, so maybe they just like second pick.
What's the difference in mentality if you're like a Radiant team? I know you in Dire Boys, you talked a bit about like pushing is more important.
Yeah, there's actually not too many advantages to being Radiant right now.
Worse.
Yeah, basically. I think it's just worse. With the new map changes, there's really not too many benefits.
All right, so Newbee do get their Phoenix. The Void got banned second stage last game. But they're going to grab it here first stage. And it was the crit Earth Spirit to open things up.
The only like major differences I can think of is that the Ancients from Dire are like, well, I guess it's another Dire advantage for the offlane, but the Ancients are just so much closer.
The only advantage I can think of for Radiant is that another advantage for Dire.
I don't know.
I mean, back, like, what, half a year ago, there was, like, this mentality amongst at least some players that just, like, being on Radiant and pushing up felt better. It's like a really weak argument.
That's mostly for less experienced players, I think. But.
Yeah. I mean, it was like some pro players mentioned it. Like we talked about it on EG like a couple times here and there, but it's more of a mental thing, not like a tangible advantage on the map.
Yeah, it's definitely some players do prefer to be playing down the screen rather than up the screen. There is that, and not just in Dota, but in other games as well, which is, well, that's how you feel, I guess. That's how you feel. Peter shaking his head.
What are we talking about?
Let's talk about the draft. Batrider gets picked.
They do have two forms of initiation now with Earth Spirit and the Bat.
They also have the Earth Spirit who can move a lot, can potentially help secure the Bat's lane a bit. Moon not having a good start was definitely an issue last game.
Void's a really tough hero to zone as like one support. There's only like a couple that can actually zone out a Void entirely. Sometimes you'll have like your carry can help you, whether it's like a Klinks or a Drow Ranger with the orb effect. He can kind of orb walk behind the creep wave and help you zone out a Void, but with an Earth Spirit, I don't think they'll be necessarily committed to zoning out a Void solo, so maybe we'll see Fly on something a little bit stronger in lane, perhaps.
Maybe a Disruptor?
I don't even think Disruptor can do it. Maybe, we always go through with Bane, but Bane's not always the best hero. It's not really that bad at all this game, though.
Yeah, they took a Disruptor in the second game that they played against Newbee in the group stage. That one ended after 28 minutes, though, so.
Yeah, maybe not.
So Newbee banning the Lycan. Again, not so the OG have run a whole lot, but they have basically no objective taking potential right now, already two picks in, so.
Venge, Phoenix are banned, so that kind of leaves Disruptor or Dazzle for Fly. And Dazzle seems like kind of where they would go, that since they have two initiation heroes, an Earth Spirit and Batrider, but Newbee always has the potential to pick AA as well, which combos really well with Void and is incredibly good versus Dazzle.
Yeah, what are they going to combo with the Void here?
Well, they already have the
DP already got banned. Let's see. They've run Klinks with it.
Yeah,
they've
run
Klinks. They're still Invoker.
From a support point of view, they've run the Lion with it before.
I mean, they run the Lion with almost everything.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you just want damage to dump into Chrono, but the Lion does get banned now.
And they've also used the Darkseer as well.
I'd say Void Phoenix and like one more is pretty much all you need.
If you go AA here, though, you're lacking any like control or playmaking potential from your supports.
Okay. Take a Miracles Invoker.
I think that's... have they been playing Quaswex? Or has it been Exhort?
They have not been running too much of the hero. They ran it once against Fnatic.
Did they have Void?
They did not.
Okay.
That was the game where they ran the KP Naga, so it was kind of a curveball draft. I think it was Quaswex, though, I want to say.
I'm not totally sure what we'll see here,
Let's see.
I think that...
Oh, no, it was actually Quaswex.
Weaver might be a pretty good likelihood for how this game.
Well, they do go with the Fly Dazzle.
Yeah, man, I got this. I got this.
There you go. TI winning drafter right here.
I mean, you gotta play what you know, and OG is, you know, picking some of their staples because that's what got them here, and that's what you need to do. And Dazzle's great this game. There's nothing that says it's not a good pick this game. Unless they pick AA.
Well, but I guess like you said, AA Phoenix isn't the greatest support combo.
It's really not.
You don't have any disable from those two. They're both very level dependent. They're not that good at moving around early.
Very static, and you can't help lanes.
And you're against Earth Spirit, and Earth Spirit will be moving, so I don't think that's the way Newbee's headed.
Disruptor's okay for Chuan. That's one of the heroes he's been playing a lot.
Yeah. Pretty good against Bat.
Yeah, great for Bat.
Good for chasing follow-up kills after a Chrono. Spirit.
Silence is nice for Dazzle.
So just looking back on their last set of games against OG, they haven't run an Invoker in any of those games.
I think Newbee will take their support hero here and then wait on their, since they have the last pick of the draft.
Oh, they do go AA.
They'll be able to see both of OG's heroes here, which they're going to see their mid and their carry, and then they're going to be able to last pick Howe's here, or they could run Void for Howe, which he has played before, and then they could have KPI play something else.
Like Slardar, for example.
Slardar's still in the pool. That's an option, but maybe even like his Naga or something along those lines.
Okay.
Or Tidehunter is still very, very good.
Yeah, both of those heroes great against the Bat Initiation, especially.
Definitely.
Do you think Tide makes them super cooldown dependent, though?
No, I don't think so. I think with Tide, they can just walk down a lane, and if Batrider tries to go, Tide's going to have a Ravage and a Mech, and Phoenix is going to Sunray whoever they go on, and that person's not going to die.
So OG really haven't shown anything about their overall game plan here. Just solid laning supports and an initiator, but we don't see if they're going to go for more split push, more farm. They know they're fighting a huge team fight right now.
Yeah, Newbee's safe lane's a little weird. Like we talked about Phoenix and AA being not the best support duo, but AA does kind of secure your lane with the Chilling Touch. So maybe Crit will roam up there in Batrider and try, or on Earth Spirit and try to help out Bat, but.
I mean, once in a while, OG has run the No-Tail Bat, something they've shied away from a bit recently. Oh. Any chance of that coming
out? I'd be
out?
Really surprised if they did that. I think this tournament, it's been Moon that's almost always.
It was like every game at Shanghai, but yeah, it's definitely been different.
I mean, they didn't do that well at Shanghai, so.
We're talking about going back to things that work, so. Yeah. Maybe not.
I'm not sure what No-Tail hero we'll see here.
Juggernaut was banned last game.
But it's tough when you have these fourth and fifth picks because you need to pick a hero that's not going to get totally counterpicked by that last selection.
Okay.
There's a lot of ways to deal with refraction here.
Yeah.
We'll know a lot more about OG's hero when we see this last ban.
TA is a good matchup against Invoker, but you know, beyond that, there's Phoenix to deal with it, there's AA.
Phoenix is incredibly great versus TA.
Yeah, on paper it looks like a hard TA game in the mid game, but they do have Earth Spirit TA with even the Dazzle may be able to TP if needed, so perhaps they're just trying to crush the lane. You mentioned laning being really important here, and there's a matchup where TA can do
well. Barrier's great versus AA, great versus Invoker. He's okay versus Phoenix.
They don't have a great way to deal with the Lasso Initiation.
Not yet.
But they do have one more pick.
That's true. They don't have, like, last game it was Chuan on the Lion blinking as soon as Moon would blink in and Lasso, Chuan would blink in and go on the Bat. They don't really have that this game. AA is not going to be able to kind of initiate. So Phoenix can maybe get an Axe. And, hey, can you take someone out of Lasso with Axe? I'm not totally sure.
I mean, we don't really see very many Phoenix Axe. So.
Yeah,
if it gets to that point, if you've often.
I just don't know what kind of effect that has. I know you can't snowball someone out of Lasso. So.
I'm not sure. So they banned Dro again. Two games in a row now, fifth banning the hero. Just really, now with the Lycan also has been banned, so there's no, like, just pick this hero, win all the lanes option.
Yeah, it's a huge focus on lanes for Newbee right now. Yeah.
Slark ban.
The strange thing about the Drow is they played OG.
That's new.
The Drow. And Newbee won very easily. Naga for fifth pick.
So this is one of the ways to counter big team fights. Silencer used to be a hero teams would experiment with. Song, obviously great for resetting fights. Can also split push and just prevent them from ever five manning with the combo.
It's true. It's a lot of burst, though. I don't know if necessarily Naga Sleep is going to save someone. They're going to get chronoed, there's going to be a Sunstrike, and there's going to be an AA Blast.
And if it all dumps in, it may not matter.
The rest are just right clicks at that point. So
they do have Grave as well. So,
but if Naga's a great hero to give them lots of vision, that will allow them to kind of figure out where Newbee's heroes are throughout the game and maybe dodge some of these team fights or maybe find themselves taking favorable fights.
So what pulls it together here for Newbee?
something to deal with.
The lasso as well.
Ember Spirit. Sven still in the pool, I think.
Weaver. No, there's the Ember.
Very nicely done. It's fine.
What a trap.
It's all good. We've got PPD here, and he's saved
last
the panel
place,
entirely.
Last place, Manila Major, guys.
Final thoughts, Charlie.
This is a new look for OG. Have we ever seen a no-tail Naga Siren?
Not here.
I don't think so. No. Been Peter, a while.
What do you reckon? Who's got the better draft?
Man. It's going to depend on Moon once again. If he gets anything out of the offlane. If he gets things out of the offlane, I'm a fan of OG. Otherwise, I'll just take Newbee again.
Okay. Key man Moon. LD.
It's definitely a new look from OG, especially. I think Newbee being Direside with this much team fight, this much AoE, I just think this is an overall comfortable draft for them. So OG have to win lanes. I favor Newbee here.
Okay. All right. Thank you to all three of our panelists. We'll head over to our commentary team for game number two.
Thank you very much, Paul. Indeed, game two now of OG versus Newbee. Let's not waste any time as we get into game two.
OG versus Newbee.
So indeed, here we have it. Gods, let's talk about this. OG bringing something a little bit different to the board. No tail Naga Siren. What's your thoughts?
Normally you get excited when you see a player on a new hero combo, but Naga Siren, maybe not the most exciting or flashy hero, but we're going to see what No Tail can do in this hero. I'm curious to see OG and how they can pull this off and how it changes things with this team, because this is probably one of the last heroes I would have expected out of OG at this tournament.
Absolutely, and it's going to be very interesting to see how it does against Newbee's lineup. I mean, they've got an incredibly strong composition, that infamous Void combination with the Phoenix, and the fact that they've taken Miracle's Invoke away, they're going to put Mu, of course, on it in the mid lane. The carry Howe on his Ember Spirit. The one weakness that the panel did talk about, though, is the fact that between the AA and the Phoenix, maybe a little lack of lockdown, but have Newbee compensated for that elsewhere enough, do you think?
I mean, the Ember's that good tempo controller who has that short cooldown disable. You've got an 8-second cooldown on Searing Chains. It can set up a cold feed, so this fixes a lot of the problems. KP getting aggressive bottom, but similar on the OG side, not the best lockdown, at least early on. You've got Lasso once for initiation later on. I think the big reason Naga works here is because Newbee, this game 2 draft, very different than game 1. It's much more, you see the Void Phoenix, it's teamfight, you're playing around your big ultis. The Ember Spirit can solve the Naga problem a bit, but unlike last game, you're not worried about Newbee running at you 10 to 15 minutes in the game with Slaughter and Lifestealer. This time around, Newbee have to play around the cooldowns a bit more. They're also just not as fast tempo with a draft like this.
Absolutely. And looking over to OG's lineup, do you imagine the kind of play style that they're going to look for is kind of the combination of Miracle, Moon, and Crit to be those playmakers looking for the action around the map where you have, obviously, Fly on his Dazzle, looking after No-Tail, trying it to get into that stage of the game where he's going to be this, you know, unstoppable late-game force. Of on top lane, Moon in trouble, and Moon gets the Sunstrike on point. Moon will start to take the salve. In fact, Crit trying for the first burn. No-Tail's actually going to find it on the bottom lane. Action going on globally here. OG with the first blood. Can Newbee find Moon in return? They are trying their best here. Moon's giving them a bit of a workout. And he is going to try and deny himself here to the neutrals. He's not going to be able to do it, though.
Oh,
try and finding the kill. And Crit's actually rolled into this. He may end up giving Newbee a second kill if Howard Twan could get away with this one. Chains come out, and Newbee will take a second, going the way of Howe on the Ember Spirit.
Ooh, Crit will be regretting that one for a while. But the first blood going to Naga, that is obviously a great pickup at bottom. Does look like KP is getting some XP out of this lane, but the first blood for Naga of all heroes is something you do have to be a little bit concerned about.
Absolutely, and I'm sure we'll see KP start to play a little bit more reserved after being caught out at the start. And the mid lane matchup, it's going to be interesting to see how that pans out, having this TA against the Invoker. I mean, obviously, you know, during the draft, Miracle, he's going to be picking up the TA if he feels confident in the matchup. He knows Invoker incredibly well, so we should expect to see Miracle do all right in this lane.
Mu is one of those mid laners. He reminds me a lot of Fat, is that people don't talk about him. Mechanically, though, insanely good. That is not like a, he's not like some 9k MMR player or anything, but he will win his lanes, and even lanes that he maybe shouldn't win will do very well.
Top Moon in a lot of trouble here. The bird coming across Sunray from across the tree line. Newbee taking down another kill on this top lane, punishing Moon for the second time. Moon maybe needs to tone down the aggression up here. Level 3 now on the Phoenix.
He's playing kind of extra aggressive because he's had the backup of Earth Spirit constantly, so he wants to try and set up these kills where he can get two or three Napalm stacks and have crit roll in. But he's just being kind of, he's kind of overextending and trying to do a bit too much right now as Newbee finds a second kill on him. And something the panel talked a bit about was Moon having a good time in this lane, which so far has not happened.
Immediately as well, we're seeing how dealing very well with Moon's aggression. As soon as he tries to go in, just holding him back with the chains.
Smoke mid.
See if they can get the wraparound. We ignore the courage, just go straight for the kill. Sunray onto Miracle, eating through those refraction charges. And Miracle, can he get himself out of this one? Will pop the fairy fire. The bolt charges, will it be enough? Diving forward.
He
Miracle
jukes
it out. Miracle!
Oh,
his positioning. Threads the needle there.
The way the dive works, he just...
Oh, Frit, he's coming in to punish this as well. Kaka trying for the TP, realize it's not going to work because the stun is available for Frit, and he just moves in, lays down the rock, beats down the bird. You certainly can't kill a bird with one stone in this case.
We're talking about one of the best Phoenix players in the world having his dive dodged by Miracle there. He stands right in the middle of it, doesn't take any damage or get hit by the slow, and that is just some insane individual play out of the mid laner of OG, the 9k MMR Miracle.
Absolutely, and we need to see this high level play from OG, because game one, they got battered by Newbee. Newbee dealt incredibly well with them. They just played at a higher level. The draft, the performance wasn't there from OG, but already at the start of this game, it looks to be a much cleaner beginning.
Yeah, after the two deaths, Moon has gone back to the lane and been able to put a bit of pressure on, get some farm. He's up to 11 CS in level four, but similarly, bottom lane, Void, level 4 himself, so both offlaners having a decent time here early on.
Now look at that, the stats indeed. I've not played a professional game for 11 months on the Nagasaren Hotel. So far the farm's going good, and talking about the two side lanes, looking at the safe lane is the fact that Notail, 27 for 6 over on the top lane, Hao only 14 for 4. He's really been shut down in terms of the early game farm because of the presence of Moon and the occasional appearance of Crit.
Yeah, and even when you're getting those like the kill and the assist at top on Hao, you're not going to match up well against the Nagasaren, who's free farming away.
What? Crit, eyes onto the mid lane, getting a lot of vision down around this mid lane as well.
Have got level 6, so that means traps are online.
Crit's just going to try and find the perfect angle here. Clean out this final range creep, so the push is there, and then we have to get the creeps to Tango Town. Immediately, there we have it. The creeps are gone, so in comes Crit with the roll in. Onto Moon. Miracle, has he got the damage to deal with this invoker? He's got Moon turning up as well. They should be able to find it, and they will. Nothing the Chuan could do to save the Moon. Fire flying himself away. In fact, Kaka falling incredibly low. Needs to be careful on this Phoenix, but OG get away with that kill onto the invoker. A bit of action there, favorable for Miracle. This mid lane, 27 for 14 against the 21 for 6. A lot of denies as well done by the TA. It's looking good for OG.
Very timely rotation from the Earth Spirit, waiting for the trap slow. Even just that small microsecond of slow allowing him to guarantee the boulder smash into rolling boulder. And from there, Invoker doesn't really have a good counterplay. Hasn't got any points in Wex. There's no Ghost Walk potential. And OG even covered their bases by having Moon rotate into the mid lane just in case Newbee showed up with a lot of heroes.
This is one Miracle. He's going to try and secure himself the rune. He does have backup from Crit coming in. The Sunray, though, meaning the Miracle can't hang around to grab it. Regen will be there. But Crit, eyes onto Kaka, gets off the stun, the slow, the silence as well. Will the damage be there, though? And it's not. So Crit has to be careful now, getting himself away. Kaka dives forward. Mu closing the gap as well. And Crit, can he manage to play his way out of this one? He hasn't got anything else to throw out. Newbee will find the kill. Moon's turned up on the Batrider, trying to chase down the bird. Kaka will be able to get away as Tron is there. They'll look to turn this one. Moon still trying to find his four stacks onto the Phoenix. It's a hard kill to get. He's desperately going for it. One more touch will do it and he'll find it. But he is going to get punished. Hao turning up the reaction. But Moon at the moment, he's creating a lot of space, wasting a lot of time here for Newbee. But with the tower hitting down onto him, he will get punished for it.
He may have actually been able to TP out there. I don't know if he totally realized Hao didn't actually have the searing chains up, but either way, a lot of, I guess, quote-unquote, space created, trading his life for a support. Not really ideal as a Batrider, but Hao had to rotate off the lane, came in, used fire Remnant, and he can't TP back to lane.
Lane again, immediately with the trap, so trying to move in, onto Mu, Crit, playing it perfectly, Mu out of mana here as well. Not a lot of hope for him until the backup comes through, and here we have it, KP TPing in, but Crit with the silence, making sure that the Chronos doesn't come out immediately. Now it comes out onto Miracle. Is the damage there? There's a bash, the Sunray as well. Miracle, will he be safe? Flies there, but he hasn't got the mana, the bolt charges, keep Miracle alive. They've taken down Mu, they'll turn towards KP. OG, take two, how? Manila with the reaction, finds a kill onto Miracle, remnants up to the high ground, tries to finish off Moon. The Flame Guard taking him down with a heal from Fly, the slow from Crit holding back Hal. He won't be able to find himself anything else there. And it's a 2-for-1 for OG, but they do lose Miracle at the end of it.
I mean, all this is going on while No-Tail is free farming, remind you. Newbee are playing 5v4 Dota right now. No-Tail, Arcane Boots, Aquila starting to pressure the T1 tower. And this is going to be a big concern for Newbee, who are going to actually decide to rotate move off this mid lane. It's just been such a bloodbath there. They don't want Invoker involved in this much fighting. He's only level 6, 8 minutes into the game. Moon needs to find some farm and alone time, so he's like, okay, let's make a truce. I'll go down bottom. Me and No-Tail can have our farming time, but he does not want to go anywhere near the action.
Absolutely, at the moment. You know, Newbee, they're playing similar to how they went the first game, just reacting to every kind of play that OG is going for. But at the moment, the trades are going OG's way.
Yeah, you can kind of see what Newbee feel like they have to do. How's he even picked up a drop?
Hello. Jacka just diving away there. He's got to be careful though. I mean, Miracle, as we've seen, this man willing to play incredibly aggressively on his TA. Yeah.
The Ember of Hal has to be the one kind of to create space for Invoker at this point. Void has to play around the Chrono cooldown. You can't get kills alone as a Void. You're talking about an offlane Void with just Brown Boot and a poor man shield, so Hal's Ember with the AA Ice Blast has to be kind of the killing duo of this Newbee lineup right now. You've always got the Sunstrikes that can go flying in, but you don't want to actually fight with your Invoker outside of that global Sunstrike.
And you can see there's a bit of a nice creep stack there for the Dire towards the top by the lane. So Ember, you can see now just getting the pull across, clearing out some of these larger creeps. And this is keeping him very, very close to the farm of No-Tail. We saw at the start that Hal was falling behind in CS, but at this stage, just only a few hundred behind this Naga Siren, which has been given a lot of space. So Newbee at least able to close the gap there, mid lane Kaka. Just trying to do his best to slow down Miracle's farm with the Sunray spam. He's not going to be able to get a kill, but nonetheless going to be incredibly annoying.
He wants to hit that level 6. Could buy the Tome of XP at 10 minutes and hit level 6 and go for a smoke play, but...
Here we go with the setup down bottom Newbee. They need to have TPs, and if they want to have a chance of countering this one, the silence should be there as well in case, and it is. Brit plays it perfectly.
That is so good. They time the sleep. They take the sleep off as the Boulder Smash is going through. Meanwhile, Dazzle does get picked off by an Ice Blast, it looks like, but the much bigger kill on the Void at bottom lane, and a very well-executed kill at that. Does put Song of the Siren on cooldown, which is that long 3-minute cooldown. If Newbee want to go for a gank, No-Tail will not have that escape spell.
And at the moment as well, we see Miracle at the start. You know, when he went aggressive, they did react to him. Do the side of Newbee look to take down and punish this TA? I mean, where are you kind of looking to put your efforts at the moment?
Killing Naga is the dream scenario, yeah. Knowing that there's no Song. If you can find the Naga, it's not necessarily a guaranteed kill, it's still a 1k HP Naga, but with a Chronosphere into Sunstrike, you've got, well, no Supernova yet. Kaka's not quite there, so it looks like they're going to instead go for the easier kill on the TA.
We have it wrapping around KP. He's going to jump in immediately, committing the Chronosphere. We'll see if there's going to be any kind of save from OG. TPs are coming through, but the pure damage coming down as the head of Miracle. They'll find themselves the kill. Who's there? Not so available yet to skill it here at level 8 with the Supernova out. KP getting the batches. Moon in a lot of trouble, but Fly gets the Grave out. Moon will be able to escape. Still Kaka. Oh, the Sunray will get him. Crit turns in. Managed to get out the Magnetized. Can they stop this man TPing out? They can't. He's gone. So OG losing to Newbee. Won't be punished at all there in that engagement. And now regaining good control of this game, 9-for-7. Something else to know, of course, is this incredible timing of Chuan. And you look towards Chuan, he had a Midas at 10 minutes in.
Yeah, this 3-0-3. I mean, Chuan, as far as the, I guess, he's kind of plays that sometimes 4, sometimes 5 position support. As far as the role he plays, where he's on the 5 position heroes but gets a lot of farm, he always has these amazing games. His Lion last game, we saw it. Another Ice Blast mid, Miracle.
Oh, yeah. The perfect setup here for Newbee if they can find the follow through. Refraction's gone. Sunstrike will be there as well. It's going to be off the point, but the Sunray, that doesn't miss.
Level 4 Sunray this early on, and you cannot rely on Refraction. This is where, yes, TA, good laning matchup against the Invoker, but once you get out of that laning stage, Zero struggles tremendously against Phoenix. AA, Chronosphere lockdown, Ember Spirit. You've got so many ways to fight and deal with the TA Refraction.
A lot of this now really onto No-Tail to just continue to make sure that he finds the farm. He has 2.2k on him at the moment. I imagine the build he is going to be saving up for that relic this game.
Absolutely. No question about it. That is the build which can win your team this game. Gee, it's going to come down to creating space for No-Tail to get that range and come online. And TA, not really the best hero to fit that description, but Miracle as a player fits that description because Newbee just, I mean, they're like, okay, it's Miracle. We've got to keep ganking him. We've got to keep killing him. They've taken him out three times, but as a result, Naga's been able to free farm the lane and the jungle has 91 CS already. Is being outfarmed by Hal now, who took down a tier 1 tower, as well as being involved in a lot of kill. I mean, immediately
jumping in, Otsamoon, Sunray, Sunstrike, goodbye, Sunshine. Another kill for Newbee. I mean, this catch potential, you know, if you land this Chronosphere, you're pretty much killing anyone on the side of OG every time, as long as you have at least a plus one in a Sunstrike.
And Newbee are just being so proactive at finding pickups. It's not as fast-paced as last game in terms of taking objectives, but as far as finding fights and getting kills, it's just as fast-paced. All out of Kaka's Phoenix, it feels like.
Miracle and Hal. He's kind of playing around with each other here in the mid lane. Kaka keeping eyes on No-Tail. They do really want to try and kill this man again. 2.7k gold, No-Tail. Getting closer and closer to the relic.
Speaking of Midas, it looks like Kaka close to his as well, so we're going to be looking at very rich
triple
and high-level supports on Newbee's side. You're versing a Naga, what do? You match greed with greed.
OG, four towards the mid lane. The ping's coming out. Newbee are hanging around for a bit of a reaction if OG start to go aggressive once more. Tower incredibly low, they'd love to find that extra bit of gold by getting the final touch OG, but already Hal, eyes onto Moon, just the chains off. Some kind of follow through, from Fly and a Moon will be given the backup. Here comes the Ancient Iron Crush and Ice Blast onto Fly, remnanting forward, looking to kill off the Dazzle Hound. He can't quite get it. Sunray flying front to Miracle and they've lost the TA.
Yep.
Again, Newbee finding these huge kills and they're not done. They're moving from what's a fantastic supernova in the middle of it all. Fly will Grave himself continue to run. Now coming in from the side, he's got the slight and the chains ready at the waiting. Fly brought down incredibly low. Doesn't quite get the latch off here and Fly will survive. Sunstrike, who's it going to catch? No one for the time being. So OG will be able to keep the rest alive. Moon's got eyes onto Kaka and he'll move in. Kaka's just going to go for the TP out. He's not going to make it. Flamebreak will be there. And Moon just playing with the Firebird. Fire with fire there. And Moon finds the kill.
Al's
looking for Moon though. And with the Ice Blast, that might just catch him in. No, he can't quite get him. And with the backup of Crit, can Moon actually get himself away from this one? Time dilation coming through the slows there, but Fly. The backup Miracle's there as well. KP holding out for the perfect Chrono. Will he be able to get it off? He should, and he does. Two men on the catch of it. Yeah, they've got to get themselves out.
Kind of uses it like the Song of the Siren there just to cover the retreat of Hao, who is very low on mana, as well as the Invoker of Mu. But again, while this is all going on, No-Tail has 4k gold, has the relic money. He's ready to go, and with the T1 Tower, they'll get even more money on top of this. Kwan, not going to go for the deny.
It really is all about whether or not this is a game that a Naga can win. I mean, the later this goes, I mean, you look at Newbee's lineup, as you said, because of the way that they've been building and the heroes themselves, they're still going to be incredibly relevant towards the latter portions of a game if it ends up going that far.
It's actually, I've never seen this build out of a Batrider. He's still got no points in Flaming Lasso at level 10. He's not even going Blink Dagger. He's going straight into an Aether Lens. This is like OG saying, our plan is just to farm. We're not looking for pickoffs. We're looking just to go for these kind of more stable item buildups where we're not going to be setting the tempo. They're letting Newbee be the ones who decide how this game plays out. But for the most part, it's working because No-Tail has gone completely unchecked. Newbee have lost a bit of their early game lead here as we transition into the mid game.
Kaka is coming across the jungle. They need to keep tabs on No-Tail, check out the man's progression. Make sure that he doesn't get too out of control.
Really, just at this point, it's like too late to gank him. You've just kind of accepted and conceded to the fact that Naga's going to have a 18-minute Radiance, and Newbee are just saying, we think we can beat it with the way they're prioritizing ganking Miracle. And I think the one thing to look at as like, okay, we're giving Naga free farm, and beat it late game is they've got triple Midas, they're going to scale very well, and TA is not going to scale all that well.
Miracle, I mean, he really is going for the playmaking build here. Rather than finishing off the full Deso first, he's just going to pick up that Blink Dagger on top of the Blight Sack.
This is in some ways more defensive than offensive this game, just because with the refraction up, if you get initiated on, you can still blink away since you don't take damage with the refraction up. It does not disable your blinking. Newbee.
Looking for a big, big smoke here. But at the same time, OG. They grouped up as four as well.
And the blink also great against the void. You can, if you're fast fingers and we're talking about miracle, you can get that.
It's going to dispel. What's the reaction going to be? Immediately just trying to get themselves out of there. Crit turns around, gets a two-man stun. How? Quite get the catch off. The roll away is there from Crit. Crit and Fly, they need to run because How, he's moving in. KP trying to get close enough to land the Chronosphere. How? Chains onto two. Sunstrike as well, but it's a little bit too far for Newbee to commit. They're now starting to back up. It's a three-man Weavers. OG, they'll want to fight into this one. Kaka does have a supernova available with the lasso's there, but immediately the Chronosphere reaction. Miracle trying to finish off Kaka. He can't quite do it. Now he's got to run. The Ice Blast flying through. The Silence is done. The Flame Break KP brought incredibly low. Time walks away. He's going to survive for the time being. But oh, they still get him, the Magnetize. It will bring him down, and OG, mind to How, looking for the TP bomb, Crit with the plays! He shoots, he scores, it's a double kill for Crit! Miracle, he's still potentially got eyes looking for more. Moon and Crit are there to back it up, it's just a poor old solo AA. Goodbye, Chuan, as OG take a fourth, equalizing the scoreboard off now, 12 for 12. A huge fight for them there, and Newbee, they just were too damn aggressive, gods.
Yeah, they find themselves incredibly deep. They've already committed the Phoenix dive, and Miracle positioned himself that he blinked behind the corner, was hitting Phoenix. For a second, it looked bad for OG when the song actually saved the Phoenix for a while, but Crit comes up big. He hits the stun as the song ends, again, preventing the Phoenix from using that kind of escape spell or using the supernova. And you take the Phoenix supernova and Sunring out of the fight, and Newbee are missing one of their biggest tools, their most important tools for an engagement, and just really good control from OG, baiting Newbee as deep as they did, and then they just turn it around.
Absolutely. I mean, you mentioned Crit. I mean, he on his Earth Spirit.
It's been
obviously
the Crit show,
his
really.
Staple, but yeah, he has had an absolutely incredible performance so far. 3-2-7. He's coming up to the money for that Blink Dagger if that's what he wants to go for straight up. But yeah, what a great Earth Spirit game this has been so far. And every single timing it's been there, as you said, just to follow up the song, any kind of setup from OG. This game, I think that this is pretty much as close as we expected an OG Newbee matchup in the upper bracket to be.
Oh, absolutely, and completely unexpected with the way that this draft has gone with the Naga Siren TA duo from OG, and so far so good. OG TA is back in the game after that fight. Miracle is suddenly up there with the Invoker in terms of farm. How's the one who's also falling off now? He needs to just get back to work on that Battle Fury. But Newbee have snuck their way into the Roche pit.
Yeah, this is nice as well. If they can get away with this one, OG, got any idea that this is going on at the moment? Four towards the mid. They are going to start to make a movement across, and Miracle has a drop, ready to lay down. So they know what's up. It doesn't look like Newbee will get away with this one. And indeed they won't. You know that they've been spotted. KP still hanging around, playing around with the Roshan. But OG will be there, ready for the battle. Looks like it won't kick off for the time being. Neither team feeling confident enough to move into the pit. As we can just see, Miracle actually just posed incredibly aggressively to see if anyone comes around through this area of the jungle.
I think partly why Newbee want to take it now is because taking Roche only gets more difficult now that Naga's starting to commence the split.
Miracle could go for this mate because Crit's there as well to find the follow through. Moo will get out the Ghost Walk in time. They don't have detection, so Moo will be able to walk this one off successfully. Crit just a little bit too slow there with a follow-up silence. And Moo just too damn quick with the reactions.
OG starting to just assert dominance on the map. Being able to push out all these lanes using the Naga illusions has just given them a ton of map control. Unfortunately, they haven't been able to get too many wards up. Newbee have de-warded the recent ones, but Fly taking path into the enemy jungle will be looking to get some aggressive vision.
They can get How as well. They need Crit to hit a stun or a silence. They'll get it immediately. Immediate silence from Crit. 1-2, Miracle ripping through How on the Amber Spirit. And now this is a stage as well where Miracle just 300 gold away from the Desolator. If he has that, you know, within the next minute, as well as the Blink Dagger, it's going to cause so many issues for Newbee. And also on top of that, the fact is we constantly say that No Tail, he's had a perfect game. He's 12,000 net worth. He hasn't died at all. The Naga start, it's been perfect for him.
Absolutely. Him and Crit have really just showed up here in game number two when OG have needed it. Yeah. You have your star mid player getting shut down, prioritized. He's on a hero that's getting countered by Newbee's draft. If anything, Newbee fell in the trap like, oh, we've got this great draft that can counter TA, but leaving a Naga Siren ignored and Notel has taken so much with all that space he's been given. And he's in a great position to succeed here and force a game three, but Newbee, got that big scary teamfight lineup, and that's something they're definitely going to be looking to use with the level 2 Supernova.
Smoked up again. But look at the car, cut jumps in with a stun. Oh, miracle!
Again, it's Crit.
It's so much damage at this stage.
Every single time, you look at Newbee, you've got escape spells like Phoenix has died. You've got Ember Spirit with the Remnant Escape, Void with the Time Warp, and every single time Crit is there with the stun and or the silence to prevent those escape spells. He's been on point. And you look at these gates, you figure, okay, maybe like one or two times you're going to get away. Every single time he stopped the escape.
Miracle. Not afraid to tickle Hal. Just teasing him here on the side. But as you said, yeah. I mean, how do you deal with this just constant threat of Crit jumping in and getting that initial lockdown onto you if you're on the side of Newbee?
I think Newbee needed to look for a smoke play fairly soon again. They've recently got a full staff up. They're perhaps waiting for the Aghanim Scepter on move, but they can't just sit back and let OG dominate the map. Try and smoke up using three or four heroes. The AA has a global Ice Blast. Invoker's got the global Sunstrike. So just send like the Ember, Void, and Phoenix for a three-man smoke.
Ow. He's got to be careful. OG know he's there, and they're going to be ready to jump in. Crit immediately with the stun. The silence in there. We have it again. It really is the Crit show.
This Blink Dagger this early on is just completely wrecked Newbee. This Ember's just like, man, I'm gonna get, even when he gets this battle tier, he still can't farm. He's still so prone to just being blown up as we just saw.
Man. And it's exactly the way that we expected OG to play from the start. Having these playmakers, giving Notail this space. So you're essentially winning the game so far without Notail needing to do anything. I mean, Occasionally we've seen him come out with kind of two songs in big fights, but he's had so much space. Now he's gonna use the song. Should be a little bit of, yeah, I was going to say, just TP straight out of this one, a Newbee. It's a nice five-man gank. JK as well, OG avert it all.
They're thinking about Roche, but with Batrider in the neighborhood, I don't even know if OG are going to let this happen. Miracle could theoretically pressure the top lane with his Desolate, but he said, screw that, let's fight Roche, yeah.
Absolutely, a Newbee know this. So Newbee will look to try and fight outside of the pit. Managed to find a lock onto Miracle. Miracle could be in a bit of trouble with the Sun Ray, the Ice Blast as well. They'll find it. Huge kill for Newbee there.
He rotated past the tower at mid, and Newbee, recognizing that he was completely alone, TP the Ember in and catch him, preventing his Blink Dagger. So really nice punish from Newbee.
I mean, is Song of the Sirens down? There's no Miracle. This is a good bit of space for Newbee. We'll see what they decide to do with it. They're smoked up.
They don't kill Bruce incredibly fast, but it might just be fast enough with TA dead and Song down.
OG, they are coming across them. We'll see if they do still want to have a go of it. Crit.
It's so annoying. You've got boulder smashes, flame breaks, all these long-range stuns, and annoying nukes just flying in, and you can't even punish this. If you're a Newbee, You've got to try and jump one of these heroes that keep throwing these nukes, but an Earth Spirit has a blink. Batrider also has a blink. Now you're not going to catch these heroes.
And at this rate, Miracle's going to be back on the field.
Okay,
in time.
They've caught Moon. Messed up.
Chrono into the Ice Blast, the bat's down.
Oh, he picked up a Shadow Blade just for that initiation. I like this from KP. Talk about how to find these pickoffs.
Eyes onto Notail. Notail's alone here. He needs some help. Has picked up his Octarine, though. I mean, as we said, the farm, 26 minutes in. Radiance Octarine Naga.
Yeah, the Shadow Blade from KP is recognizing that Newbee's catch is very lacking, and they need some way to reliably initiate. Blink Dagger isn't all that good when you're against the Radiance Illusion, so gets the Shadow Blade, but the response that is likely to come from OG is you get a gem and give it to your Naga. The illusions kind of going out on the map can always see that initiation coming in.
So for the time being, both teams are just going to draw their attention away from the pit. Very, very scared, of course, of Miracle's TA, the side of Newbee. They know that it's pretty much suicide to try and go for the Roche whilst OG have these heroes alive. Especially with the Chronosphere, of course, back on cooldown. OG. Well, they're certainly not scared themselves. They're going to smoke up, move immediately over to the pit. And they themselves, with that TA, have a huge amount of damage. No Chrono for 45. This is a great timing to try and go for it. See if Newbee do head over and do contest. In fact, looks like OG may. No, okay. Here with the Sunstrike. They know what's up. Ice Blast. Nice, connects to none of them. In fact, Miracle sidesteps it successfully. G move back in. And then it has the lasso up as well. KP looking for some kind of a wraparound with the Shadow Blade, but still at 20 seconds until the Chrono's there.
The egg by the Roche Pit, very deadly to fight into. You can plant it on the cliffs. But without Chrono, oh, they'll even song.
Yeah, just to make sure. And OG take the Roche, Aegis now onto Miracle. And no response available from Newbee.
Hal's still trying to farm up his Battle Fury. He's had a miserable time these last 10 minutes. No Battle Fury, hasn't been able to farm out on the map. The punish from this Earth Spirit just keeps on coming his way.
He's in Crit Moon.
KP, what's a courier?
Everyone at the moment just being incredibly sneaky on both sides. Keeping themselves in the trees, but no one's going to catch out either. Bottom lane. Hal's got to be careful. Moon's there, ready with the catch. Jumps in. Lasso and Crit with the damage. Should be enough to bring him down, and it is indeed. Catching Hal out just like that, we've seen it so many times. I mean, Moon and Crit this time working in collaboration to find the kill, and it's successful.
He finally thought, like, okay, they've left this bottom lane. I can get my Battle Fury. No. OG are patient. They'll wait. They've figured out Hal's farming patterns. They know where he is on the map. They've just really read him well the last 10 minutes of this game. And as a result, Newbee do not have the farm they need on the hero they picked to help deal with the Naga Siren. Naga Siren, over 10k net worth ahead of Hal's Ember Spirit.
It is crazy how Notel's been farming up. But at the same time, it's not unexpected because of the fact that Newbee just haven't been given the chance to get themselves down there and attempt to deal with the Naga. We saw them go for 1 5-man gank, but the song was there. The initiation was cancelled. And ever since that, Newbee just haven't tried to do it again.
OG ready to push forward now with Aegis on Miracle. They can just be split pushing all these lanes with Naga Siren while they've got a good base breaking hero in the form of the Desolated TA. So life gets very difficult for Newbee. You have to rely on that heavy team fight of theirs. They've got to land that big Chrono if they want to stand a chance in this fight. And here there is the gem of the Naga Siren that I talked about. You get this up, you send those illusions around. KP can no longer rely on this Shadow Blade for his initiation.
Let's see how hard OG want to go in on this mid lane. Newbee, okay, side. Moon just dies onto KP top. Hal's trying to do his best to clean it out here. OG, so they're not going to be able to muster the courage to go straight in as of yet.
It's a free tier 2 tower for them to take it bottom lane. And we're talking about taking free towers into what is the big team fight lineup of Newbee. Battle Fury pick up by Hal doesn't even change all
too
much.
It's so late, yeah. It's not the timing that you're looking for as an Ember Spirit. But OG, the way that they played, the way that they've drafted this as well, they've just dealt excellently with what Newbee wanted to do this game. It's a total different story to what we saw in game one. And here we have Miracle chipping away at the tier threes with what kind of response is Newbee going to give?
It's so difficult because you've got Naga Illusions pressuring the mid lane. They're chasing Phoenix around, so they're always kind of keeping tabs of where the Phoenix is going to be. And it's just very reliable, safe damage. Miracle just slowly chipping away at the tier 3 tower, and it's forcing Newbee to make a play.
Right? I mean, Miracle just... he's finding this tower on his own, and Newbee, they're just being forced back to the base by Notel's Illusions.
Ice Blast won't even land, and Miracle's just gotten a free tier 3.
And now no Ice Blast, OG, they know that they've got the time to move back in. Just continue to push onto the racks. And Newbee, I think they're just wondering what the heck they can do. Maybe if they can find some sort of a Chronos for it.
KP,
but again, as you said, these illusions with the gems just meaning that KP can't find the jump in that he wants
to. Supernova. He used it just so he doesn't die to Naga Illusion.
Oh my goodness.
Newbee are in disarray right now. Their initiation just isn't there with the Shadow Blade into a gem.
Miracle, looking to move. One, the Ghost Walk will be there. KP gets on the Chronosphere. Can they take out the Tearbox Fly with the Shallow Grave, keeping Miracle alive? No tell. Moving into the center of it all. Ice Blast won't catch Miracle. He's still keeping his first time attacking. Crit hits onto the Invoker. The Aegis will be popped. A buyback immediately from Moo. Trying to get himself back in and hold on this defense. But KP, he's been caught out on the back lines. They'll take down the Void as well. No buyback available for 50 seconds. Now, oh, he's been lassoed in, and just like that, Miracle ripping the Ember to shreds. they'll come out with this, and at this stage, Newbee, I mean, game one, they were beating OG around in their face, but this time OG beat Newbee around in theirs. GG is cooled. What a turnaround in game two, and I mean, game three, Park, off the back of what we've seen going either way, I don't know how it's going to end up.
I mean, this game even started well for Newbee. Their early game pressure on the mid lane with the Phoenix Sunray, they constantly kill Miracle. They had the kills going their way. KP got a bit bullied in the off lane on his Void, but both top and middle lane were going well. Moon's Batrider died a lot in the early game. Miracle's TA mid died a lot, but Crit's Earth Spirit was just everywhere, finding pickoff after pickoff. OG, their mid game was just sensational.
It really was. Crit 4-2-15. Again, just the combination of his control and lockdown, the damage from Miracle's TA. And a lot of times people talk about OG kind of playing around Miracle, getting the space, but this time they just played it perfectly around No-Tail. They gave him all the space that he needed on that Naga Siren. At the end of the day, when they could come in with that push, 32 minutes in, just having those illusions, forcing back Newbee, and Newbee just didn't have an answer.
Yeah, it felt like Newbee, they had the strong early game, but they didn't quite have the same ability to just rush at OG like they did last game. Not having the same aggressive, I mean, you're not going to get the lifesteal of two games in a row when Hal plays it like he did, but you needed some way to control the tempo more and play faster pace because they were too reliant on some of the big ultimates. Void, his teamfight was there, but it, like, he couldn't find the Chronosphere ever.
Now, as you said, just the timing, the fact that when the Shadowblade came out, it allowed them to get that one kill, that one catch onto Moon, but immediately, you know, afterwards, No-Tail picks up a gem, and the whole item, the whole purchase is essentially countered. But I think we should be able to bring up Paul. Paul, are you there?
Yes, we read you loud and clear. Houston, come in. Well done. Good second game, and we're tied up in the upper bracket final. Couldn't ask for much more, could we, God?
I'm so thrilled. This is the series everyone's been waiting for, seeing it go to three games. I mean, the kind of trading one-sided affairs, I imagine game three, you are not going to see an outdraft, but this is fantastic.
Yeah. Odie Pixel, what do you make of this?
I think it's absolutely great to see. I mean, no one at this stage later on into the tournament wants to see two games with two stomps going the same way. Here, we've kind of had it either way. So as God said, I mean, game three, I don't think anyone can call really what's going to happen. We've seen some incredible stuff just over the first two games already.
I was quite happy that it was you two doing the upper bracket final, because if it was Toby, we'd probably have had two stomps, right?
Probably. Knowing the luck. But we've had a great series so far, and I think it's only going to get better in game three, Paul.
Absolutely. Thank you very much. We'll come back to you in game three. We'll get the thoughts of our panel right now, and we'll start with Charlie. 1-1. Good display from OG after a rocky start as well.
Absolutely. Something we talked about before the game was that the fact that Phoenix and Ancient Apparition are two very static supports, and you contrast that with the Earth Spirit of Crit, that guy was everywhere. He set up so many kills, so many silences on Ember, and it changed the way that they played. If you notice that, yes, Kaka played great, went on, shut down Miracle early really hard, but the fact that he was able to be everywhere on the map really created so much space for No-Tail.
Yeah, Peter, you highlighted that the two supports didn't necessarily synergize well with each other, and that kind of showcased it, really.
I mean, I think they played really well. You saw early game they were setting up kills in every single lane, but there comes a point where Naga is just pushing every single lane, and these two supports don't really do too much. They just kind of watch Naga farm and wish they were something else.
11 months since No-Tail was played the hero. Didn't look it, did it?
No, it felt like they were very comfortable with the hero. And I mean, on top of running the passive supports, they go for triple Midas and a Battle Fear and Ember. So it's a very farming oriented draft. But that basically meant come mid game, like, Naga is just going to have free reign unless every chrono is immaculate. And so many good dazzle saves later on, too. That early dive mid where Fly was able to turn it around. I just felt like they didn't have the impact hero from the supports more than anything.
I think it was just a really, really good game for that Naga pick. We haven't seen No-Tail play it at all, but if there was a perfect game for it, it was this one. All he had to worry about was where Void was. And if he could find Void anywhere with any one of his illusions or any TA trap or, you know, maybe Batrider, if, you know, he was ganking Batrider, No-Tail could go wherever he wanted and do whatever he wanted to do.
Yeah, you also highlighted the draft depended on Moon quite heavily, and he had a good game.
Yeah, and he had a pretty good early game. It wasn't spectacular, but he was kind of got a little more scrappy and ran into their jungle. He ran mid with Crit and made plays happen on the mid lane.
The cool thing was Crit had such a good start that Moon, he went for like the drums, Aetherlands build, didn't even skill up lasso. I think it was until level 11 he got the level 1 lasso, because he didn't need to. Crit was the only initiator for the team, but he got so much done that Moon could play a little more economy focused, didn't have to rely on the blink lasso to start fights, and
Yeah, and that
he kind of had an easy role from there.
Kind of comes back to the supports. They just Newbee just didn't really have any heroes that did things. They just had a bunch of heroes that sat there in lanes, and you know, they just watched Naga farm to the point where there's no return.
Crit MVP is the unanimous decision. Mm-hmm.
You saw Moon and Crit. Yes, they died a bit early game, but they're like running deep into the enemy jungle, and you saw like Hao had to respond, the Phoenix had to respond, the AA had to respond. And it was just, they don't have the right heroes to be able to deal with, like, a Batrider and an Earth Spirit just running all over the place.
And the other thing was, like, I like the way they played around the big ultimates, right? Because if you're constantly taking fights, you're constantly applying pressure to the lanes, Chronosphere's on cooldown, they forced out the egg in quite a few fights where Kaka didn't have the optimal initiation. Sometimes the Chrono got blown defensively, you then immediately see OG try to push the advantage. So if you're going to run this very teamfight-heavy, reliant lineup, you have to hit the big combos. But if you don't do that, an OG, they punish, you're in a rough spot.
Yeah, let's take a look back at the highlights. The early game was not good for OG, I have to say.
Just some sidestep god out of Miracle right now.
Yes. Under a lot of pressure early, he still was farming pretty well here, and I think shortly after this is when you really start to see the Earth Spirit effect. But moving forward, KP with some good early rotations. I like the way they used the Void early, not afraid to drop the Chrono, but again, Dazzle, Earth Spirit, these two coming up so big in this fight. Miracle gets incredibly low. I think Ember triple Remnants in right around this time. Double Remnants in, and then he chases for another. They eventually get the TA, but they had to commit so much on him, and as the game got later, he gets a little more farm. They just couldn't find the kills.
Yeah, if you notice in that fight, AA is never there, but you have four heroes of OG all running mid. It's because these heroes like AA, he just wants to sit in the lane and get his level 6 and throw an Ice Blast here and there, but after he does that, his teamfight contribution is pretty much nothing.
It's just all space for Naga, and the great thing that, you know, if Crit was an MVP, I was going to give it to No-Tail. He took his farm, and he made space for his teammates with it. Miracle didn't have this outstanding, you know, 9K MMR, oh my god, game.
Best player in the universe.
You know, he had a couple deaths, but there I mean, eventually, Naga got so far, she got a Radiance, and she started pushing out all these lanes, and this put so much pressure on Newbee to make these kind of questionable plays in the mid-game, and when Newbee slipped up, the rest of OG was there to capitalize. Yeah.
Early game, you go for that big dive, you get the kill in the TA. Not a problem because Naga isn't pressuring elsewhere. But later on, when she has Radiance, when she has Octarine BOTs, if you go for that dive, first of all, you may just feed your supports away, which we saw later on. They would just couldn't deal with the Radiance burn. And secondly, you might lose objectives too. So as it got later, it just got harder to get away with that type of play.
I think going into next game, we'll see Chuan back on one of his Disruptors or Lions or
playmaking support.
Exactly. So a little bit more do stuff kind of hero.
Yeah, I think we'll see a lot of focus mid again. Like in the first game where Newbee won, you saw the Bounty Hunter Kaka constantly mid. This game, you saw Crit on his Earth Spirit constantly mid. And it was those mid rotations that won these respective teams their games.
Yeah. But give credit to OG in the draft because they banned the Chuan Lion. Yeah. So they know where Newbee get their strength from in the mid game.
Yeah. Likewise, in game one, we saw the Earth Spirit ban. I was a little bit surprised, but they played against it before and won. Perhaps it was an odd thing. Now we realize why. I think Newbee we're not going to let that one through, are they?
Go with what you're comfortable with.
I mean, they can play it. Kaka is definitely one of the top Earth Spirit players, so maybe Newbee want to run it, but I don't see them picking it first stage, and as a result, probably they either ban it or have a plan to deal with it.
Yeah, and Fly looks pretty relieved after that game.
Yeah. Yeah, there seemed to be a bit of tension on the players. I said that when they came out. They just seemed slightly different from when I've seen them come out, and they're all happy and smiling and waving to the crowd, and this time around they were very almost morose when they came out. So.
Newbee's had their number for so long. It's got to be frustrating to lose to them so many times.
Yeah. What does it do to you then when you finally pick up a win against the team that almost become like your bogey team, and then you finally do win? Is it like a mental click that you kind of go, oh, okay, we can beat these guys?
I think you got to pat yourself on the back for the draft. Yeah. I didn't really identify it, you know, when it started, but I think the Naga pick was really, really good.
Mm. Wait and see what they do for the. But
I think Newbee's draft was really disappointing though. Like I think the Phoenix AA that we talked about was just not very Newbee-esque at all.
Yeah, the AA felt tempting on paper because of the Dazzle matchup,
but
it doesn't fit their overall play style.
Yeah, like they always been running these like tri-cores and then run at and they fight all the time, but with only Void to initiate, they're totally dependent on whether or not this Chronosphere is on cooldown.
Yeah, I mean, compare that to Slardar. Like, they could just fight constantly with KP in the mid-game. Even the Bounty Hunter is always able to fight. Lifesteal is running around, so I would like to see heroes with lower cooldowns.
Yeah. It felt like an overcommitment, just tailoring your entire playstyle to counter one support pick.